Alright, fourth grade, last lesson of the day, last lesson of the week, and that is Language Arts Lesson 6. Did I hear you groan? Another Language Arts lesson today? That's right. I'm doing this to help us catch up on the week that we lost. Probably won't have language arts 2 times in a day very often, but it's happening today. Lesson 6, and this lesson you're learning or discussing, we're discussing figures of speech and personification. And this isn't anything too new, because you've been working with this in reading. I'm going to read from your pink box. Figures of speech. Poetry uses figures of speech to create interesting pictures in our mind. Figures of speech are phrases that do not mean exactly what they say. Figures of speech are phrases that do not mean exactly what they say. For illustration, I'm going to go ahead and read this poem, The Fly, written by Walter de la Mer. And be on the lookout for figures of speech, and then we'll talk about what we see in this poem. How large into the little fly? Let me start over. How large unto the tiny fly must little things appear? A rosebud like a feather bed, its prickle like a spear? A dewdrop like a looking glass, a hair like golden wire? The smallest grain of mustard seed, as fierce as coals of fire? A loaf of bread, a lofty hill, a wasp, a cruel leopard, and specks of salt as bright to see as lambskins. I said that wrong. Let me start over with the second to the last phrase. And specks of salt as bright to see as lambkins to a shepherd. Did you identify any figures of speech? Third line, a rosebud like a feather bed. We know that a rosebud is not a feather bed, but to a fly, I bet that's how it appears. And to a fly, the thorn on a rose stem probably looks like a spear. Did you ever think what a fly thinks when it's crawling through your hair? Crawling through a mass of wires. A loaf of bread, a lofty hill. We know that bread is not a hill, but to an ant it's a hill. These are examples of figures of speech. It is really interesting to think about these things. Create pictures in our minds, and yeah, it just helps us to think about the world in a new way. How would it be like to be a fly and to look at a human coming my direction? How would it seem like a mountain walking our way if we were a fly? Okay, well, let's talk about personification. Page 23. And I'll read the introduction in the pink box, the first paragraph. Sometimes in a poem, the writer makes animals or things act or talk like people. This is a figure of speech called personification. So, personification is a figure of speech. It is a type of a figure of speech. So, something, an animal or an object, doing something that only humans can do. I'm going to read a poem that has some personification in it, and we'll talk about it after I finish reading. See if you can pick them out. This poem is written by Nancy Bird Turner, and the title is A Popcorn Song. Sing a song of popcorn when the snowstorms rage. 50 little brown men put into a cage. Shake them till they laugh and leap, crowding to the top. Watch them burst their little coats. Pop, pop, pop. What did you pick out as personification? It is describing the little popcorn kernels as 50 little brown men put into a cage till they laugh and leap, shake them till they laugh and leap. It's describing those little 50 brown men as laughing and leaping whenever those kernels start exploding into popcorn. Watch them burst their little coats. That's a cute poem. And a really good example of personification. Okay. We will move on to a couple things in your lesson. Part G, I'll give you a chance to turn there. The directions say, write an example of each kind of word. Write an example of each kind of word. Action verb, being verb, singular possessive word, and so on. So use your hardware, use the tools that you have. Those tools would be your glossary, they could be your laminated sheet that I sent home with you. Those things can give you clues to think of examples. And then part I, the bottom of the page, write a sentence using each tense. So think carefully about those and make sure that your verb in the sentence has the proper tense, present, past, or future. And also remember, these are sentences, so begin with capitalization and end with proper punctuation. That's all for today.